Unfortunately, this is beyond my skill level. Those marks around his mouth aren't right. Muscles are completely contracted. Whatever happened to this boxer, he didn't die from his wounds. Poison, maybe. I'm no expert, but there's gotta be some way to figure out what killed him. Just grab a blood sample from his mouth. Maybe Scott can tell me more.
Boy, I have a favor to ask you. I've lost something.
What'd you lose?
I mentioned one thing. Oh, I am sorry. In fact, it's about a friend. Charles? You remember Charles? No, you can't remember him. Silly me, you never met him. Anyway, Charles is a friend. A scientist co-worker. He was way more successful than I must say. So, he's a friend, and I lost him. It looks like he disappeared, and I am a bit worried. I know that he was doing some sensitive research. Important. Maybe he ran into problems because of that. Anyhow, it's hard to tell.
How do you want me to find him?
He has an assistant. Very nice. She used to make delicious pastries. Unless I'm mixing her up with someone else. Anyway, he had an assistant. I'm pretty sure of it.
I'll go find her. She must know what happened to him. And if she does, it'll turn out the professor is just in a conference somewhere.
Maybe. It's true I don't get invited to conferences as often as I used to. It's rather unfair. I used to love the cocktails they serve.
Could you take a look at this blood? It's a boxer who got killed, and I need to know what happened to him.
You have suspicions as to how he died? You know, boxing is a violent sport. Maybe he took too many hits. I've already seen head traumas that were so violent that the brain looked like jelly. Or maybe... Oh, yes. You want an analysis. Maybe he'd been on drugs. Give it to me. I'll look at it. It'll take me a couple...
So...
This person... A boxer, you said. He was put in prison. No doubt about it. Nobody would use jellyfish venom to boost oneself. It's a very dangerous venom, you know, and very hard to extract. There was someone... let me think. Yes, that's it. A merchant who was selling items for hunters. Would you believe that the guy had learned how to extract venom from jellyfish? It was quite daring. Because they blow up, you see, so it's complicated.
Thanks a lot, Scott. I'm gonna go see that merchant.
Sorry, pal. Nobody enters this office if they got no pass.
That right, pal? I'm an officer, and a technomancer, and I'm here to see Anton Rogue. Think you should let me in.
You even know who Anton Rogue is? He's the big fucking balls here. The boss. I don't care if you're a damn general. Get the hell out of here.
What else?
Show it to me. All right, fine. You can come in, even though you're dressed like... you stole it from one of our guys.
Look what the cat dragged in. The prodigal son. A diamond in the rough, risen from poor street trash to the godlike ranks of Technomancer. Now tell me, Why am I so lucky to be in your presence?
Word is the slums have formed pockets of regime opposition, and you might know where they can be found.
People who oppose the regime? I am shocked. Shocked and appalled, and certain of nothing.
Then don't be a snitch. Just stand back and watch as their bombs go off and your precious streets are overrun with guards. I'm sure you're smart enough to know that that can't be good for business, though.
You're one smooth talker, Rogue. Clearly smarter than you look. Find the bar, the curiosities, and you'll find what you're looking for. The garden where the seeds of anarchy are sown. Or so I hear.
Thank you. I'll go check it out right away.
As would I. Just find them before they blow the city sky high, will you?
Unfortunately, this is beyond my skill level.
You! Please!
Rebels are close. I need to get closer to hear what they're saying. Just gotta keep this straight and stay hidden.
Where's the next action going down? You heard anything?
Operation Cut's going off in a few hours. Bulgakov's taking care of it, taking a bomb down to the train station in one of those military bags. With all the troops moving around the area, nobody'll even look twice.
Fucking regime won't be able to ignore us after that. Freedom or death, right?
If they're trying to hit the train station, Lieutenant, we gotta stop them. Do you know how many people they're gonna kill? And we'd be cut off from the other cities and Abundance's enclaves. Holy crap, even the aqueducts would be shut down.
Shadows, can't that one shut up? Who gave us this newbie? Shut up!
I wouldn't put it that way, but yes, David is right. Better if people don't know what we're up to. Panic, coupled with a bomb, could end badly for everyone involved.
Hey! Hey, you! Please! Please stop! I need your help! Please!
Leave this bag, please.
It belongs to you? Yeah, I figured, but I was expecting...
A man? Sorry to disappoint. But since you're here, minding my business, maybe I should introduce myself. I'm Bulgakov, one of the leaders of the opposition army. You gonna arrest me now?
Arrest you and take that bomb before it does any harm to the city.
You don't have a damn clue, do you, officer? That bomb was never meant for the city. This is our city, too. It was meant to take out the access roads to the city, to block the army convoys. It's time this fratricidal war finally came to an end. You think we're fighting for Aurora? You're wrong, officer. The opposition is made of patriots, and the war we're losing is making the true patriots weaker, while the politicians and their secret police grow stronger.
You're no patriot. A patriot would let her voice be heard at the Assembly of the People, not set off bombs in the city she claims to love.
You couldn't possibly be that naive, could you, officer? Ask around. See if you can find just one person who dared to speak up at your precious assembly and is still around to talk. The only voice ever heard from is the Watchers. The rest are silenced, and will continue to be until only the ASC agents remain. Stay suspicious of me. It's your right. But I don't lie, officer. I'd never hurt the people on purpose. I only ever wanted to free them. Let me. Don't stand in my way. Because it's the only road to a better abundance.
You're no hero, Bulgakov. Just a delusional woman with a bomb big enough to blow up a train station. And you're under arrest.
Then I'll be damned if you're going to take me without a fight.
Surrender, Bulgakov. ASC's on their way.
No, please. I couldn't bear. The ASC will make me wish I was dead. Show mercy and end it now.
You're looking for Bulgakov? Here she is. Great Master said the caravan would be right here, but the stand looks like it's been deserted. I'll question the neighboring merchants.
Are you looking for merchants? Got some things to buy, Lieutenant?
You should have told me. I could have done it for you.
Mr. Mancer, it's a pleasure to make your acquaintance. Big on weaponry, I hope. What can I get you?
I was expecting a caravan in the stall next door to buy a few things.
They arrived yesterday, but truth be told, I think they found some trouble. I wasn't there when it happened, but from what I heard, some people were looking to talk. Then talking turned to shouting, and after that, they were seen down in the slums. I hear, and then they were dragged into some warehouse. Whatever they did, they're in big trouble now. If you're looking to help them, you better find them fast.
Unfortunately, this is beyond my skill level. Door's locked from the other side. Guess we're going around. Hello?
Hello. Looking for some medicine? Drugs? Ingredients, maybe?
Can you help me? I'm looking for any information on the caravan that sets up in the stall over there.
I don't know. My memory sometimes needs incentive to remember.
How about this? You tell me what you know, or you'll find yourself in a room with others who'll be a little bit more assertive in their efforts to refresh your memory.
All right. Fine. I'll tell you what I know, but at great risk to my own ass. You've heard the tale of the Vori, of the underworld. So these overpriced foreign merchants did something to piss them off. Didn't pay their rite of passage or protection serum or something. Whatever the hell it was. They were kidnapped, that's all I know. Where they are, or even if they're still alive, I haven't the damnedest clue. For that, you'll have to ask the Vori. Now do Joe a favor. Take this herb and get the hell out before you raise suspicions.
To that man? The chief of the Vori? You know that even back at home we used to hear about him? He's a terrifying man. And hanging out with the mob. Those merchants are that important to you?
Mr. Mancer, the sight of your face has started to give me agita. To what do I owe the displeasure this time?
I'm looking for a caravan of merchants. They were supposed to be in the exchange. Word is they were escorted to the slums, and you may know something about it.
Yeah, rude little men. My town, my streets. Uninvited competition who lack even the common decency to offer a little token of grace in exchange for their presence. If you're ready to settle their debts, I'd be happy to usher them back home.
These merchants were involved in some outside business that requires interrogation as soon as possible. You can either help me find them, or we can always turn our attention towards your business affairs. Your call, Anton.
So either I turn a blind eye, or you do. Fair enough. Very well. Let's be magnanimous and hope that you will be too. You will find your suspects in one of our warehouses. Go see the guards and tell them, he who profits will deserve honor. They will give you the keys. Business is business, and now that ours is done, I will trust in your discretion.
I gotta go.
Then go.
Anton Rogue sent me. I need the keys to the building.
Oh yeah? Then I'm the Towser. What? I'm just supposed to believe you? Right, because I'm a moron. You looking for trouble, you just found it.
Make the slightest move, you're dead.
Come on, guys, let's get him! Yeah!
Unfortunately, this is beyond my skill level. Need a key to open this door. Fortunately, this is beyond my skill level. Door's locked from the other side. Guess we're going around.
Come on, guys.
Who are you? You don't look like a guard to me.
Because I'm not. Name's Zachariah Mancer, lieutenant in Ophir. If you're the merchant who got himself kidnapped from the exchange, I'm here to get you out.
I am indeed. Fiorello, master of the caravan. The shadow still protects me. But I doubt you came to help us out of the generosity of spirit. Am I correct in that presumption?
Ian Mancer, great master of the Technomancer, sent me to talk to you.
Ah, I see. Yes. One of my favorite clients. And a man with whom I, indeed, have some information to share. Aurora has discovered a new site, not far from the Shadow Path. A site filled with objects of incredible condition, and even a relic, as rumor has it.
News I'm sure the Great Master will be glad to hear. You should go now. Get back on the exchange as quick as you can.
I'm not one to dally, Mancer. I'll see you around, I'm sure.
Fortunately, this is beyond my skill level.
Come on, guys, get him!
Zachariah, a pleasure as always. What may I do for you?
I finally managed to meet the merchants you told me about. It wasn't easy. The mob kidnapped them for serum. I freed them before talking to them.
I'm sure gratitude helped to loosen their lips. So what knowledge was gleaned from such lengths?
Word that Aurora is running large-scale excavations along the shadow paths near our territory, and in the process uncovering important objects, maybe even a relic.
Fascinating. Finds that are no doubt better off in our hands than those of Aurora's technomancers. Keep those merchants close, Zachariah. Information like that is such a priceless commodity. You are no more free to roam than the rest of us. Of that I have no doubt. But if you find yourself with access to a rover and perhaps find a way to that excavation site and locate the relic, well, you cannot know the value it might hold if brought back to us. It may seem petty. It's a mission for some rusty relic that may or may not even exist. However, if you are able to slip away from Ophir...